Section 2.3, the metric system. This video will help you measure in centimeters and millimeters with a ruler, understand the metric system, and convert units of measure within the metric system. So we're going to start by measuring in centimeters and millimeters with the ruler. And so all measurements in the metric system are based on our number system, base 10. So it makes measuring much easier and also converting much easier than it is in the US system. Let's go ahead now and take a look at some examples that will help you understand how to measure in centimeters and millimeters. So example one, we're asked to determine the length of the nail in centimeters. Well, so on our metric ruler here, the centimeters are the larger units, and this is not to scale, so this is a little bit bigger than what a centimeter is, but we've blown it up here just so you can see the measurements more closely here. So the centimeters are the larger one, and so here I have 6 centimeters. And then notice in here are the smaller ones, these are my millimeters. And so millimeters, in between each centimeter, I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 millimeters. And that makes this really nice to measure because now instead of using fractions like we had to use in the inches, we can just go ahead and use decimal numbers here because it's base 10, just like our number system. So if I'm measuring this first nail here, and let's say if I draw my line up there, let's say it's right about there. This is just going to be 3 whole centimeters, and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.6 centimeters. Since this is base 10, I can just have 3.6 then centimeters. Man. Now let's take a look at an example that will help us understand how to measure in both centimeters and millimeters. So here is our metric ruler here in centimeters and millimeters. The centimeters here are the larger units, so 1, 2, 3, those are my centimeters. The smaller units here are the millimeters, the tiny little ones are millimeters. One thing to note here, this is not to scale. This is a little bit bigger than what a centimeter and a millimeter is. We've just blown this up so you can see what's going on here. So one thing important to note here is notice that there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 millimeters in every centimeter. And that makes this really nice because now we can use our number system, our base 10 number system, and use decimal points to make measurements here in the metric system, as opposed to like the fractions that we had to use when we were measuring in inches. So here's what that looks like. Let's say here's the nail that I'm trying to measure, and let's say we're trying to go to that point right there. So the size of this nail then is 3 whole centimeters, and I'm going to put a decimal point, and then we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 tenths of a centimeter here. So that's just going to be 3.6 centimeters. Let's go down to example two now. Now we're asked to determine the length of this nail in millimeters. So let's see here. I'll draw my line up there. So I want to count all these little tick marks, but that's actually pretty easy because notice in every centimeter there's going to be 10 of them. So I would kind of think here, here's 10, here's 20, 21, 22. So that's just going to be 22 millimeters. Go ahead and pause your video player now and answer practice questions 3 and 4. When you're done, hit play to see how you did. Okay, practice question 3, looks like the nail comes right to there, so that's going to be 4.7, so 4.7 centimeters. Okay, practice question 4, looks like we're going right about to there, so that's going to be 10 millimeters, 20, 30, 1, 2, 3, 33 millimeters. And again, we use the abbreviation millimeters, double M there, centimeters with CM. Understanding the metric system. Meters, liters, and grams are the 3 fundamental units of measure. And they are length for meters, volume for liters, and weight for grams. Prefixes are added to these fundamental units when larger measurements or smaller measurements are needed. Each prefix is a power of 10, so the metric system, again, matches our number system, making it really easy to convert units of measure. So if we take a look here, here are our 3 fundamental units here. Meters for length, liters for volume, grams for weight. Now, if we want to make these fundamental units bigger, we either add this prefix, deca, which means we're going to have 10 times the amount. So deca would be 10, for example, if we were talking about meters here, deca would be 10 meters. And then hecto would be 100 of these meters, and kilo would be 1,000 of these meters. Now, if we want to make these meters smaller, then we use these prefixes. Decimeter. So a decimeter is 1/10 of a meter. A centimeter, 1/100 of a meter, and a millimeter, that's 1/1,000th of a meter. Now, it's important to memorize these prefixes, and you're going to have to memorize these prefixes, but we have a little saying here that will help you. And notice, King Henry doesn't usually drink chocolate milk. And so, King is for kilo, H is for hecto, deca, U, that's kind of a little bit tricky, but that's the unit, the original or fundamental unit. So that's the U right here, our units of either meters, liters, or grams. Then drink for deci, C for centi, and then M for milli. So while it's easy to make conversions in the metric system, most of the time folks in the United States don't have a lot of experience with the metric units of measure. So here's a little information here just to kind of get you used to some size. So here are kind of some did you know facts. So a 5 kilometer race is a little over 3 miles. So notice a kilometer is smaller than a mile because five of them, it takes 5 kilometers to make 3 miles. So 1 kilometer is just a little over a half a mile. A dime is about 1 millimeter thick. So if we take the width of the dime, it's about 1 milliliter thick. A liter is a bit more than a quart. And a gallon is not quite 4 liters. So a liter is a little bit more than a quart. So if we take 4 liters, it's going to be a little bit more than a gallon. 1 meter is a little bit longer than 1 yard. A 1 yard is about 9/10 of a meter. So a meter stick and a yardstick are just about the same size. A meter stick's just a little bit bigger. And here are some visual pictures here to help you kind of get a handle on this. So notice this is a picture of a bridge here. And so this distance here would be a kilometer, and then a mile is going to be almost twice that amount. A meter here, so here are some children and here's the meter stick. They're holding this meter stick and you can see that it's about, and with the door there, it's just a little bit past the door handle. Centimeter is about the width of a paper clip for 1 centimeter. A kiloliter, one of these great big giant wine barrels here, just one of those would be a 1 kiloliter barrel. Liters, you had a lot of experience with that. Most water bottles are served in a liter size. A milliliter is a very small amount, and that's usually gauged on the side of a syringe. So there's a 1 milliliter on a 5 milliliter syringe. There's 1 milliliter shaded. A kilogram is 2.2 pounds. So a kilogram is more than a pound. And a pineapple is about a kilogram. An average size pineapple is about a kilogram. A gram is a very small amount of weight. And usually sweeteners, not sugar, but the sweetener packets, the alternative or zero calorie sweetener packets are usually about a gram. Now let's go ahead and pause your video player now and answer practice question 5 just to get a feel for the size of the different metric units of measure. When you're done, hit play to see how you did. All right, practice question 5. Identify the metric prefix and the fundamental unit that most conveniently measures each. So we want to have both the prefix and the fundamental unit. All right, so the volume of a soda bottle. Well, the volume of a soda bottle, that's going to be a liter. The length of a notebook. Well, what will we use to measure the length of a notebook? You could use millimeters, but those might be a little small. So I think that centimeters would be a good choice there for the length of a notebook. The perimeter of California. Now we're measuring a very large distance. So we want kind of the equivalent of miles in the metric system, and that is kilometers. The weight of a person. Typically, weights of people are measured in kilograms. Since grams are way too small, that's the size of one of those, the weight of one of those sweetener packets. So a kilogram is what we usually measure the weight of. The width of a classroom. This would be kind of the equivalent of yards or feet, which we use in the U.S. system. But here we're going to use the meter. The volume of a syringe. Now we're talking about a very small volume here, and those are usually measured in milliliters. And that's a milliliter, not a milliliter. Okay. One thing up here, I use an abbreviation for kilogram. Let's go ahead and write that out. That's kilogram up there. Convert units of measure within the metric system. Since the metric system was modeled after our number system, we can perform conversions by simply moving the decimal point. And so here's a kind of our metric conversion chart here. It's labeled this way, kilometers on the left, going all the way down then to millimeters on the right, or same thing with liters, now kiloliters, all the way down to milliliters for volumes, and then weights, kilogram, all the way down to milligram. So notice, they share all the same prefixes, and they're organized the same way. We just change out distance, volume, and weight using either meter, liter, or gram. And again, to help you remember this, King Henry doesn't usually drink chocolate milk. Let's take a look at some examples here that will help you understand how to convert now in the metric system. So, example 6, I want to convert 200 grams into kilograms. So all we have to do now is start at grams, so we're starting right here at grams. I want to convert 200 grams into kilograms. So to move from grams to kilograms, that is 1, 2, 3 to the left. 3 places to the left to get to kilograms. So all we have to do now in this 200 grams is move the decimal the exact same way. Now in the number 200, the decimal starts over here at the right. And I just need to move that the same way I moved on my chart, which was 1, 2, 3 places. So I'm going to move the decimal. 1, 2, 3 places. So this is 0.2 kilograms. Okay? Make sure if we're writing a decimal point here, especially if you're going in the health professions, we put a zero out front there. Okay? Example 6. We're converting 6.1 kilometers into decimeters. Well, let's see. Kilometers to decimeters, that's 1, 2, 3, 4 units to the right. So I would take this 6.1 kilometers now, and I'm going to move that 4 places to the right. Take the decimal, 1, 2, 3, 4. I'll add my zeros in there. So it looks like 6.1 kilometers is equal to 6, 1, 1, 2, 3. Looks like 61,000 decimeters. Go ahead and pause your video player now and answer practice questions 8 and 9. When you're done, hit play to see how you did. All right, question 8. Convert 45 decagrams to milligrams. Well, let's see. Decagrams are right here, and we want to go to milligrams. So that is 1, 2, 3, 4 places to the right. So I'm starting here with the number 45. Remember, when we have a whole number, the decimal starts on the right. And I want to move this decimal now 4 places, 1, 2, 3, 4 to the right. So 1, 2, 3, 4 to the right. Add my zeros in there. So it looks like 45 with 1, 2, 3, 4 zeros. So it looks like 450,000 milligrams. Question 9, convert 1.5 meters to kilometers. All right, here's meters to kilometers. 1, 2, 3 to the left. So I'm going to take 1.5, and I'm going to move that decimal 3 to the left. 1, 2, 3. So there's my decimal. So it looks like 1.5 meters is equal to 0.1215 kilometers.